Yes. How are you all doing? I want to say I love you guys. I love you all so much under the Most High God. The God of heaven and earth loves you more than I do. More than I do. Okay. All right. I promise you to reveal to you where Bishop Oyedepo of Winners Chapel, where he's paying his own tithe. I've revealed to you the word of Adeboye. Yeah, Adeboye. Right now, I'm about to reveal to you where Oyedepo is paying his own tithe. Okay, so I told all of you, everything I'm saying here, I'm not saying it because I'm not here. Germany know all of them. Though when I'm here, I'm seeing them. But I saw them better when God took me down to Nigeria. So many of you will be surprised. How is he knowing all this? Our God is everywhere. He's everywhere. I mean, I'm here in Europe but in Germany. I'm here, but I can see everything going on. In Nigeria, I can see in a good day if God decides to show me. Well, why not? He showed me everything. I see everything that's going on. Unless he do here, unless maybe the time I've not come for him to reveal to me. It's when he decided to do that. He revealed to me, he loves me so much. He revealed everything that's happening. Especially when I've been to pray and disturb him. I've been to disturb him for something. You reveal to me. So this is it. That's why only a fool. We say there is no God. There is God, but Africa need to know that God. They have not known what they are doing. They don't know God. And I am out to introduce this God, the God of heaven and earth. I want to introduce him to Africa and to the whole world at large. Okay, now I go straight to the point. Oyedepo, you know, in Africa, Cotonou is the smallest land or the smallest country, one of the smallest country in Africa. But they are the one, their shrine in Cotonou is the highest in the whole Africa. They are small but powerful when it comes to voodoo, when it comes to evil power, when it comes to a shrine, they have the strongest. And Bishop Oyedepo is going to Cotonou. There is one native doctor in Cotonou, a very strong native doctor. And the brother, the man that related to this native doctor, is my friend. The man in their family, in their lineage, there is this gift that they say that they inherited from their forefathers. Native medicines like agbo, you know, some call it, in Yoruba people they call it agbo, but it's native medicine like leaves and herbs and the roots, you know. So this man goes inside the bush and anything that is sickness or disease or anything that's happening to man, this man can be able to combine leaves and herbs and roots, you know, and give to you to drink. So this is what the man told me, that they inherited from their forefathers. He came to advertise this medicine to my friend's office. So this is how we knew each other and when we became friends. So this man is from Badagry. It's a Yoruba man, Badagry side. But the native doctor is in Cotonou, okay? It's in Cotonou. So he told me one time I was talking about Oyedepo. So he sat down that day. He was listening to what I'm saying. So when I finished talking, so I was talking to people. Because I always face people in Nigeria telling them about the pastors. Anywhere I go, I I keep on exposing them in Nigeria that these people are not from God. And many of them don't know that I came down from Europe because of this pastor. So find out what is going on. Because God had been revealing to me in Germany before I was taken down. So I've been seeing it, but I saw them front and back when I am now there in Nigeria, because I followed everything up, spiritual, physical, to really find out what is going on in Nigeria. And what is the secret, or what is this people operating with that caused Nigeria to be smelling? So this man was listening to me. So when I finished this man shake his head. I was saying everything God gave to me. So this Oyedepo have a native doctor. This native doctor is related to this man. So now Oyedepo goes there in the night. He doesn't go to see this native doctor in daytime. And when he arrived there, anytime maybe anybody wants to visit the native doctor, you don't go straight to see them. They will dress the person according to the way that the shrine or the chief priest, according to how they want the people to dress. If you come with your suit, you must remove it and dress according to the custom of that shrine, of that that place. So you dress and go and walk inside. So Oyedepo have been coming there, have been going visiting that native doctor. Then this man said his own brother is also doing pastor towards Oyedepo church, towards it's in Lagos, but it's not Ota, but towards that side. The family member of this native doctor is also doing church ministry something in Lagos. So, and that pastor was in the house. He knows that Oyedepo is coming to visit that native doctor, Baba. That, because I told that Kotonu, is the one that have the highest shrine. So they know that he do come to see the man, and he do come in the night. So he said the man also came, the pastor came, being that native doctor is their family member, so came to see the man. Not knowing that Oyedepo is there. And anytime Oyedepo, came in, when anytime they come in, the people give gap because they know that he is a well-known person. So they would just, the man will give him special attention to attend to him. So the man was waiting outside the pastor of that pastor that is related to that family is also there. So when he finished, he came out. So the native doctor said, "Oh, call him, oh, pastor, call his family member, pastor. Oh, you are also here." He said, "Yes." He said, "So when I ask the man, you're also a pastor?" He said, "Yes." So he now asked him where. The man said that he's afraid. Don't want to tell him that he's in Lagos, so that he will not send people to come and kill him for knowing that he's coming there. So the man told him, "Oh, in Ghana." The man told him, his own ministry is in Ghana. He said, okay, the Lord be with you. So the native doctor now turned back and told Oyedepo, "Why are you always coming in the night? Try to come daytime. Because what we are giving you, you are going to operate in the daytime. Why are you coming to take it in the night?" The native doctor just like a joke, like pass it to him, like, "Why are you always coming in the night?" So this is where he is going to pay his own tithe. When they correct, they take money from you. When they take money from you, they also go and give to the one that gave them power, that is renewing their power. They also go and pay their own one-tenth there, because devil is the one that is in charge of one-tenth. So this native doctor in Kotonu, where he is visiting, knows that these people are not serving God. That's why he told him, Why are you coming in the night? Why are you coming in the night? And they will come there and stand and be brewing grammar. These people are native doctors. These were occultic men. These were Illuminati. And if people talk to you about what they are doing, that these people are not of God, you will be the one opening your dirty mouth, you know, defending them and shouting and because I look at you people, you don't know anything. All of you down there, all of you are blinded, hypnotized. People should stop worshipping material things, don't know where it comes from. So, as I said to you, this is the place, not only two, but this one is just the place that is a popular place that he normally visits. It's a popular place that he normally visits. So when the man say that he shake head when his brother told him that Oedipo is coming here every time, that he shake his head. This is a Yoruba man. I was telling him what I'm saying, what God is revealing to me. He said, what you are saying spiritual, it is like that. It's happening physical. Okay, so when they finish, they give tithes to the devil, to the native doctor. Tell me how you will not be hypnotized, how your life will not be stinky, how you will not be facing an attack, how premature death will not be happening because the devil is nothing goes for nothing for the when it comes to devil. Bring head and come and take head is the devil. They will go to the devil. Devil will give them one head and tell them to return 100 head. So you can understand why Nigeria is in thick darkness. Why occultism, why ritual fill that country. Why evil is increasing in Nigeria. As the church increases, this is how evil is being increased. It's increased every day. But all these churches must be burned to ashes, must be consumed by the fire of Holy Ghost in one day.